Hey, what's up, InfoSec addicts? Joe McCray here with another mentor moment. Do you want to take your skills to the next level? Do you want to be a deep technical IT security person? No, I don't want to be the firewall guy. No, I don't want to be the guy creating VPN accounts. No, I don't want to be the guy doing alerts tier one at the security operations center working at the SOC. No, you want to write malware, or you want to analyze malware. You want to write exploit. You want to be a pen tester who's really good at bypassing, you know, EDR solutions and web application firewalls and all that kind of stuff. Like, if that's what you want to do deep technical IT security, I think this video is going to be the one that you need. Let's get started. I had a couple of people who really kind of helped me with getting over just being a regular security analyst, working tier one in a security operations, doing network security stuff, like being the sysadmin who's got some security things in his job, but you're not a full-time security person. You know, I was in those kind of job roles, and then what did it take for me to really kind of get there? So the first thing, going to hacking conferences and participating in Capture the Flag events regularly. And then I actually started hosting my own events. I used to run a website called rootwars.org. And I learned so much being involved in hacking competitions and hosting my own. Quite frankly, I really wasn't good enough to even play in my own. I barely could play. But because I started hosting them, I started getting so many people playing, and each week I would have to learn more just so I could even manage the games. So that really helped me. Being around other people who are doing it at security conferences, and then participating in these events, and then starting to host my own. Because I was hosting my own, I was the one who was able to control the servers, implement the login solutions in place, so that I could get better at learning like how people were doing stuff, why people were doing stuff, and it helped me build a network of people I could ask. So that was the first thing, being involved in conferences, and Capture the Flags, and then eventually hosting my own. The second thing was I had a conversation with a guy, his name is Dino Dizovi. So Dino Dizovi in our world is like Michael Jordan. Like, this guy is like a beast when it comes to writing exploits. And we were sitting at a bar at Black Hat, and we were talking about research and development. He told me, he was like, yeah, Joe, I mean, I always dedicate 20% of my week to R&D. 20% of your work week? You know, if you think, if that's a 40-hour work week, he's saying that he's devoting at least one full day to research and development. So think about it. If you've got a regular job, right, you're a sysadmin, network admin, tier one security guy, something like that, and you want to move into being a more deep technical IT security person, you're talking about dedicating, outside of your job, 8 hours a week, like a full man day every week on those things I just talked about, right? The things from number one. That's a lot of time. And for me, that was like this huge, huge, like, oh my God, like that much? And over my career, I'd be lying if I told you I did that. I did do it, but I wavered. You know, I had some years where I spent a lot of time, and I had some years where I really kind of tapered off. I passed a lot of certifications, and once I really kind of got a job and got better, I kind of got lazy. I can't lie and say I didn't. I really got lazy. I had kind of one of those moments where it dawned on me, like, you know, Joe, man, you're kind of being a hypocrite. Like, you're teaching all these classes, but you're not really willing to get out and learn more yourself. The guy who really helped me with that was a guy named Vivek Ramachandran. He's the guy who runs Security Tube, now called Pentester Academy. He's spending hundreds of dollars a month in books so that he can do all this research and he can develop his own content at the time. I don't know if he does it anymore. It really kind of hit me like, God, Doc. And I remember thinking to myself, man, I don't feel like doing that. You know, buying $400 or $500 a month in books and doing my own research. Ah, I don't want to do it. And then it kind of hit me like, well, man, I'm teaching and I expect people to put in the work to learn from me. damn, I really do have to do that, right? Like, what kind of hypocrite am I, right? So that was kind of one that really, really kind of hit me. Another one was from a guy's name is Mario Sabalos. Mario Sabalos, MC in the Metasploit framework. If you look through a lot of the Metasploit exploits, especially the older ones, you'll see MC. And I would say in terms of someone who was like really instrumental in like helping me like figure out like this is what I wanted to do, he really kind of helped me because at the time, I had really never seen any minorities doing this. I mean, you know, you're talking the early 2000s, you're talking like 2003. 2004. I had never seen somebody black, somebody Hispanic. I'd never seen anybody doing this stuff. So I didn't know how to pursue it. I didn't know how to be around it. I would go to conferences and I'd feel kind of out of place because I'm the only black guy there. It's all techno music. And not that I don't like techno. I do, but I like hip hop. I like R&B and, you know, black people. We like to barbecue. Like, you know, these people don't do the same things that I like to do. Now, with the love of hacking, it was the first place I had ever been where it was cool because people didn't care that I was black. That was the first thing that really attracted me to the hacking community. But I would say the not feeling, you know, like you're with your people, that really was kind of weird for me at first. And then he really kind of called me out. Because I was like a big Dan Kaminsky groupie and I would follow all these speakers at DEF CON and Black Hat all over the place and ask them 50 million questions and take all these notes. You know, you would make fun of me, quite frankly. And Mario, I remember one day Mario was like, yo man, you need to quit being a bitch. What? He was like, yo man, you need to quit being a bitch. Sit down and do the work. Like, if you want to be good at this, there's no book that you can read. There's no just asking somebody a question. What you need to do is you need to sit down and do this. No one comes out of the womb knowing how to write exploits. No one comes out of the womb knowing how to break into web apps. You're not born with it. It comes from work. You have to sit down and do it. It's not like I can ask a couple people, I can mess around a little bit here and there. If you want to be good at this, you really need to sit down and do it. And it is not going to be fast. It is not going to be easy. It's going to be a ton of work. But if you want to be good at something that other people in the world not only are not good at, but even have trouble comprehending, you're going to have to do things that they don't do. And that is really hard work on hard problems. Man, I can't thank him enough for not only how much it chin-checked my pride, but it was the catalyst for my career. I mean, it really was. There was another guy from a hacking group called Ghetto Hackers. His hacker name was Crocodile, his first name was Tyler. Tyler was one who just kept telling me, you need to make sure that you're always working on technologies that automated tools aren't solving the problem. So whatever is the security problem that right now we don't have a tool for, that's what you need to be working on. So those were the key things that I felt like really kind of push me over the edge. And again, I'm not saying like I'm some world-renowned expert and I'm the best in the world, but when I think back on my career, those moments, those, you know, 4 or 5 moments were the key things that really kind of changed my trajectory and changed the way I look at security. And I hope that that advice helps you. So this is Joe McCray from InfoSecaddicts for another mentor moment. You guys take care.